Good morning, student. As I already explained you the format of the cash flow, now we will see the problem. It's a very simple and easy problem without any adjustments. So under cash flow system, already I told there are three main heading: operating, and then investing, then financing activities. And here we are talking only about cash. When I talk about cash, what are the things included in cash? It should be cash. Cash means which is there in your hand or in your pocket, that is our cash. And at the same time, cash equivalent. Cash equivalent means bank balance and marketable securities. So in this problem, first we see where is cash. Cash is an asset, so definitely come on asset side. So here, where is cash? There is no cash, but cash equivalent is there. What is that? Bank balance. So here it is a bank balance. And they have given for 2 years. 2019 and 2020. So 2019 is treated as beginning, 2020 is treated as closing. So bank balance, beginning balance was how much? 11,000. And closing balance is how much? 15,000. So first and foremost, when you take the problem, first you have to check on cash and cash equivalent. So here the cash and cash equivalent, you have only one item, that is bank balance. 11,000 in the beginning and closing it is 15,000. First we will take the here as per the format. I've just written the main heading, but I've not answered it. So we will see. You can see here cash flow from operating activities, under that net profit before tax, then non-cash and non-operating items. After that I have cash flow from investing activities. Next, cash flow from financing activities. Nothing I have filled, I have just given the skeleton of the format. Now I am going to fill with all the flesh and blood here so that you get a very good the picture of this. So net, what we will see here is, see, the cash flow from investing activity, cash flow from financing activity, and there is a cash or cash equivalent at the beginning, cash or cash at the end. So now you tell me, here you can see at the beginning it is 11,000, at the end it is 15,000. So at the beginning, how much is there at the beginning? 11,000. At the end, how much it is there? 15,000. At the end, there is 15,000. After that, net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalent. So you can check here, in the year 19 it is 11,000, in the year 20 it is 15,000. That means there is an increase. Increase by how much? Increase by 4,000. So it is a positive answer what you got, 4,000. So net increase in the cash and cash equivalent, 4,000. Now you have to say from where you got this 4,000. How you got this 4,000? What are the changes you did in all the these three headings? So operating, cash flow from investment activity, and financing activity. So don't get confused. We will go one by one. We'll start from asset side. So we'll start from asset side. First we'll go to machinery. And already I've told you, here we are not taking any figure in the balance sheet. We only consider the changes. First we'll go to machinery. In the year machinery, it is 2,10,000. In the year 2,20,000, it is 2,80,000. What does it mean? There is an increase in machinery. Increase in machinery means there is a purchase of machinery. If asset increases, cash decreases. Why cash decreases? Because you purchase it. So here what is happening? Machinery, 2,10,000, 2,80,000. That means you are doing a purchase of machinery. And machinery is what type of asset? Machinery is fixed asset. So all fixed asset will come under investing activities. It will come under investing activities. So here we will write now, there is a purchase of machinery up to how much? 70,000. So you have to write that will come under investing activities. Purchase of machinery. Purchase of machinery. How much? 70,000. By purchasing machinery, cash is coming in or cash is going out? Cash is going out. Going out means negative. So only I will write in bracket, we have to write, so we will write in inner column first, 70,000, and it is in inner column. I mean to say bracket, because it is a negative. When there is a negative, we will write in a bracket. Why, ma'am, negative if you ask? It is negative because cash is going out. When cash goes out, negative. When cash come in, positive. So, by purchasing machinery, cash is going out 70,000. Next comes to the next asset, debtors. Debtor is a current asset. Debtor is what? Current asset. So, all current asset will come under operating activity, but there is one more heading, that is net operating profit before changes in working capital. Before changes in working capital. So under this you have to take that net operating profit. This is operating profit before changes in working capital. So now first debtors. What is happening in debtors? In the year 19, it was 96,000. In the year 20, it is 83,000. What does it mean? There is a decrease in asset. When asset decreases, what is coming in? Cash is coming in. It is positive. So you have to write down how much debtors. Debtors, how much it is decreasing? It is decreasing by 13,000. Debtors, 13,000. Why it is decreased? Because some debtors would have given cash to you, would have given goods on a debt basis, they have given goods cash to you. So when they give cash, the debtor will reduce and cash account is been credited. So what is happening here is cash is coming in. What's happening? Cash is coming in. So when debtor decreases, cash is coming in. Asset decrease, cash is coming in. Asset increase, cash is going out. Any asset. Next, stock. Stock is also current asset. So what is happening with stock? Here 60, here 40. So what is happening? Again there is a decrease. So when asset decreases, what is happening? Cash is coming in. Again I will write down here, stock. How much? How much? 20,000 difference. Again it is also positive because cash is coming in. After that, what asset next you have? Discount on issue of debenture. Actually these discounts are happened before incorporations, and these discounts are treated as non-operating expenses. This is treated as non-operating. Again the rule is same. If asset increases, cash is coming in. So again 3,000 and 2,000, there is a decrease of 1,000. So where you have to write that 1,000? It will come under non-operating items. So that is discount on issue of debenture. Discount on issue of debenture. Discount on issue of debenture. How much? What is the difference? It is 1,000. Discount on issue of debenture, 1,000. There is a decrease. Next, bank balance already taken. Next, come to liabilities. Share capital. Here, what is the rule? If liability increases, cash increases. If liability decreases, cash decreases. Very simple. So, share capital. In 19, it is 1,80,000. In 2020, it is 2,00,000. Means there is an increase. So, when capital increases, cash is coming in. And share capital comes under financing activity. So, write down share capital. How much there is an increase? There is an increase by 20,000. There is an increase by 20,000. Next, depreciation. As I already told you, depreciation is non-operating expenses. So it is non-operating expenses. This will come under here non-cash or non-operating expenses. So here I will write down depreciation reserve. Depreciation reserve. Again, there is an increase. If liability increases, cash increases. Liability decreases, cash decreases. There's an increase by how much? 2000. There's an increase by how much? 2000. Next comes very important, P&L. That here you don't have net profit, but you have P&L. Opening and closing. Opening how much you have? 45,000. Closing how much you have? 72,000. That means there is an increase. The difference what you get is net profit. If it is a negative value, it is net loss. But here it is a positive. Positive value how much? Net operating profit before tax. How much is net operating profit before tax? That is 27,000. That is a difference between 45,000 and 72,000. Next comes debenture. And debenture has been decreased. So you can refer here, debenture is decreased. When debenture decreases, what will happen? Asset, when liability decreases, cash also decreases. That is a negative. So debenture is a financing activity. So where you have to write? Under finance you have to write debenture. And there is a negative, that is how much the difference? You can see 60,000 and 54, there's a difference of 6,000. There's a difference of 6,000, that is negative. Next comes to creditor. Creditor is a current liability. And creditor also decreased. Any liability decrease, cash decreases. So 35 to 32. So there is a decrease by how much? 3,000. So you have to write here creditors. And there is a negative value, how much? 3,000. There's a negative value, 3,000. Now we will total this. Here by total you have to write, and this one total, and the last this one total. You have to write. So first 27,000, add 1,000, add 2,000, add 13,000, add 20,000, and minus 3,000. So how much you will get? You will get 60,000. It is a positive. So how did you get this 60,000? This 60,000 is from net operating, cash flow from operating activity. You got the 60,000 from cash flow from operating activity. You got 60,000. Next, you are getting, the next one is investing activity. From investing activity, you are getting negative value. That is 70,000. You are getting negative value, how much? 70,000. 60,000 is from operating activity, 70,000 is from investing activity. Next, you see from financing activity. From financing activity, you are getting positive answer. How much is that? 14,000. You are getting positive answer, how much? 20,000 minus 6,000. 14,000. So total these three, ultimately you should get how much? 4,000. Then your answer is correct. 60,000, 70,000, 14,000. You add these two because it is positive, you'll get 74,000. Minus 70,000, you got 4,000. So before only we are knowing the answer and you are doing the problem and matching to that answer, then you are 100% correct. So now you understood from where this 4,000 extra you got. There is an increase in cash flow. How it got increased? So you are understand, you'll be getting to know through these activities. Okay, thank you. Good morning, students. Hope you are all fine. Take care of yourself. Today I'm doing cash flow statement. So before doing cash flow statement, we should know the meaning of cash flow and statement. What is cash? Cash is a most liquid form of asset. It is a medium of exchange. So cash is money. Money in your pocket or in your hand. So that is called cash. So cash here, does the cash only means which is there in your pocket or which is there in your hand? No. Cash and equivalent to cash. So what does cash equivalent means? Cash equivalent means bank balance. Suppose you have cash in your bank account. So then that is also considered as cash. Say for example, someone, you have to pay money and you have given him a check. So that check, if he go and dropped in a bank, then he will get the cash. So cash means a most liquid form of asset. That's a medium of exchange. And even equivalent to cash, the equivalent to cash is even bank balance is considered as cash. And then marketable securities. Marketable securities are those securities which can be easily converted into cash. See, these money market instruments are easily converted into cash. You have 1 day to 182 days bills, treasury bills and all. It can be easily converted into cash. So those marketable securities, cash and bank balance are all treated as cash. So what are the things comes under cash? Under cash, we'll get the liquid, the cash which is there in your hand, the cash which is there in your bank account, and marketable securities. All the three is considered as cash. Next, what is flow? Flow means change. The changes happening in the cash is called flow. Why the changes happens? All those things we study in this flow. Flow means changes. Then comes statement. Statement means whatever the changes happen in the cash, making a documentation is called statement. What is statement? Under statement, what we do? We do a documentation. So cash flow statement means changes in cash flow. The cash means cash, liquid cash in your hand, balance in your bank, and marketable securities. Those on all those things and changes in that is considered cash flow statement, and recording that is a documentation that only we are studying today. That is cash flow statement. According to Bangalore University, we are preparing cash flow statement in indirect method. Most of the companies also follow indirect method of cash flow system. So under cash flow system, we divide the format into three main heading. One is cash flow from operating activity. The other one is cash flow from investing activity. The other one is cash flow from financing activities. See, if you want to start, why we are dividing this into three main important headings? Because, say for example, if you want to start a business, what are the things you require? The first one is you need is capital. So that comes under financing activity. Whether how to raise the capital, whether issuing equity or by taking loan, say example, debenture or loan from a bank. So those things you are deciding, those things will go under financing activity. Once you get capital, is that enough? No. You need some asset, some fixed asset to start the business. Say for example, you need building, you need machinery. So those things comes under investing activities. After that, is that building, machinery and capital is enough to start a business? No. You need stock, you have to do purchases, you have to convert raw material into finished goods, you have to make a sales. Those things comes under operating activity, that is cash flow from operating activities. So here in this format, first I will explain you cash flow from financing activity. So here is the format. We will go from the end. So what does it mean? How to prepare cash flow statement? We have to prepare cash flow statement. First you have to write cash and cash equivalent at the ending. What is the amount at the ending? And cash and the cash equivalent at the beginning. What is the beginning? So you have to see the difference here. Say for example, cash at the ending. Cash at end 10,000. Then cash at beginning is 8,000. 8,000. So cash at the end is 10,000. Cash at the beginning is 8,000. That means compared to beginning and end, there is an increase of 2,000. There is an increase of how much? 2,000. That only we will write here. Net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalent. So what happened? Whether in the beginning it was more or whether in the end it was more, what was the difference, those difference we will write here, net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalent. So here there is an increase by 2000. That 2000 will come here. And when you know, you already know the answer. There is an increase in cash flow. You already know the answer. This 2000 is, there is an increase in our cash flow. Next, what you have to do is, why this 2000, from where we got, whether it is from operating or whether it is from investing or whether it is from financing activity, we have to make the changes. So now we have to see from where we got this 2000. That's all we are doing under cash flow system. So now we will go to financing activity. Okay, under financial activity, items those comes under financing activities are cash flow from financing activities. What are the financing activities? As I already told, to raise the capital. How to raise the capital? By issue of shares, by issue of debenture. And you have, suppose if you take some loan taken. So all these things comes under cash flow from financing activity. And at the same time, when you issue shares, after 1 year, if there is a profit, what you will do? You will give as a dividend. So by issuing shares, cash is coming in. By issuing debenture, cash is coming in. By taking loan, cash is coming in. So you are adding it. By paying dividend, cash is going out. So what you will do? You will minus. When you take debenture or loan, debenture is also a long-term loan by taken from large number of people. By issuing debenture, loan, if you suppose take debenture and loan, you are liable to pay interest. When you pay interest, cash is going out. So interest paid. Then when you pay the loan taken or when you pay the debenture or when you redeem preference shares, all of you know, when you repay, what is happening? The cash is going out. So repayment has to be minused. These things comes under financing activity. After doing all the adjustments, if you have a positive answer, then you should say net cash from financing activity. If you do all the activities, if it comes minus, that is you have get a negative answer, then you say net cash used in financing activity, used for financing activities. So if it is a positive answer, from, if it is a negative answer, used in, you have to mention. After this, what I told, after getting capital, you have to invest. Where you'll be investing? On fixed asset. Anything you invest on fixed asset, those things comes under investing activity. Okay, next is cash flow from investing activity. So what will happen? You may sell some fixed asset. If you sell asset, cash is coming in. Any asset, fixed asset, current asset, any asset, if you sell, cash is coming in. Sale of investment. You have purchased some other company share and you are selling it, again cash is coming in. Next, purchase of fixed asset. When you purchase fixed asset, cash is going out. So here what you have to do is, when you purchase, you have to minus, because cash is going out. When you sell fixed asset, cash is coming in, you have to add. When cash is coming in, it is add. When it's cash going out, it is minus. Next, purchase of investment. When you purchase, when you make investment in some other company, when you purchase share of some other company, then what will happen? Cash is going out, then you have to minus it. Next, dividend received. Say for example, if you purchase the share of some other company, then you will get dividend. So dividend received will come here. Dividend paid will come in financing activity. Dividend received will come in your investing activity. Interest received, say for example, you have given someone a loan. So definitely, then you will get interest. So interest received will come here. Then you have purchased some fixed asset and given it on rent, then the rent received will come here. and you have to give importance for these things, because these two will repeat again and again. You have to be very careful with this, that for that, with problems we'll solve it. So after doing this, net cash from, if it is a positive answer, net cash from investment activity, you have to write down. If there is a negative answer, then you should say net cash used in investment activity. So financing activity and investing activity is done. Next is operating activities. So in operating activities, let's see cash flow from operating activities. Net profit before tax. This is same like your trading account and profit and loss account. If you remember your trading account and profit and loss account, then solving this operating cash flow from operating activity, it is easy. So here what we will do, first we will write down net profit before tax. That will be given in your problem. After that, add non-cash and non-operating items. See, there are some items like depreciation, loss and all, where usually the cash may not go out. So those things you have to list out and you have to add. What are those things? Depreciation, preliminary expenses. These expenses are the expenses that happened before pre-incorporation, before the incorporation of the organization. Discount on issue of shares and debenture. Now there is no share, it's only on debenture. Discount on issue of shares is not there. Next, patent return off, again goodwill return off, underwriting commission, loss on sale of fixed asset, provision for doubtful debts, tax provision. Here literally the cash is not going out, but they have been shown as expenses. So what you have to do, you have to add all those things. After that, what you have to do is, these are the items which has to be minus, that is deducted. Less items to be deducted. Rent received, see, again I am telling you, it is rent received has come here also and in investing activities also. So only we are minusing here, it is coming twice. So only we are minusing here. So rent received, interest received, dividend received, profit on sale of fixed asset or investment. You'll understand it better with a problem. So items to be deducted, these four items if you have in your problem, here you have to minus. Next, operating profit before working capital changes. So operating profit before working capital changes means, all of you know, working capital means current asset minus current liability. We have already taken all the fixed assets, we have already taken all the shares debenture, but we have not touched current assets and current liability. So that, those things comes here. So what are the things you have to write here? Operating profit before working capital changes. What are the things you have to do here? Add decrease in current asset, increase in current liability. Guys, this no need to bahat. You remember, if any asset, it may be any asset, if asset increases means what? You are purchasing asset. When you purchase asset, what is going out? Cash is going out. So when asset increases, cash decreases. When liability increases, liability means issuing share capital, issuing debenture. So when liability increases, cash also increases. So here what is happening? Decrease in current asset. Suppose current asset decreases, that means you are selling some assets. When you sell some assets, what is happening? Cash is coming in. So you have to add. Whenever cash comes in, you add. Whenever cash go out, you minus. When you sell some asset, cash, what will happen? Cash is coming in. So decrease in current asset, you have to add. Increase in current liability, you have to add. And opposite to it, less. Increase in current asset. So suppose current asset is increasing, what will happen? Cash is going out. So you have to minus. Next, to this is decrease in current liability. If liability is decreasing, means say for example, your loan you are giving out. That means you are repaying your loan. when you repay your loan, what will happen? Cash is going out. So decrease in liability, you have to minus. By doing this, you will get cash generated from operating activity. If it is positive, you will write cash generated from operating activity. If it is negative, you have to write cash used for operating activity. You have to minus. So there only I have shown, no, from means positive, used for means negative. After doing this, you have got to know all the three activity: operating, financing and investing activity. Next, here on last adjustment is, you have whatever profit you get in this adjustment, you have to minus the tax. After getting here, you have to minus the tax. If you minus net operating profit after tax, you will get the profit after tax. So you have to minus the tax, you will get profit after tax. So this is the format. So in this format, you have to remember three headings will come. The first heading is operating, the second heading is investing, the third heading is financing activity. So for this one small problem, I will be explaining now and we will finish the chapter.